Greetings, and welcome to Let's Play My Channel Logo. This is the third time I'm trying to record this vlog. The first time I stopped because I was sounding like it sounded like a Second World War hate speech or something. The second time I had to stop because I wanted to play FTL while doing it, and while recording, well, the first 3 or so minutes, I realized the screen was stuck, so I don't know, that never happened. So I decided to go back. I'm a little bit more calmer. I'm not playing a game. So let's focus on the vlog. I wanted to address a few things. And one of those things was the last two streams. I'm not going to upload those streams to YouTube, mainly because the games that I'm playing are, well, I'm not going to finish them. And I make the big rule that if I know I'm not going to finish a game, I won't upload videos of that. Halcyon, for example, was I wouldn't have known after 10 hours or so that I won't upload this game, so that's a let's play that is unfinished, but yeah. Anyways, the main problem I had with the games were I was really looking forward to play them, and they just bedded me over and fucked me. Bastard Bonds looked really interesting, and it still is a good game. It's just really repetitive. I have no problem with repetitive games. I mean, I have 70 hours in Factorio, but I'm not good at streaming them. And the chat was also pretty silent on Saturday. No, there's no little complaint. A lot of people were missing. So I was like, yeah, okay, that's not fun. Fuck it. The day after, I wanted to play Seven Mages. A dungeon crawler, like Legend of Grimrock. Looked really interesting. It wasn't fun at all. I don't know what's up with these more modernish games in the dungeon crawler variety, Legend of Grimrock excluded, who think that people like the combat aspect of dungeon crawlers. I don't know, the combat aspect was always the, I wouldn't say uninteresting part, but you need a good mix of puzzles and combat, you know, to even it out. I'm not playing Dungeon Master because straving around worms all day was just so much fun, which is also one of the main reasons I don't really like Chaos Strikes back. I just don't like the game. So there's that. Then again, Chaos Strikes back does have some puzzles in it, so I have to say this, otherwise some people will complain. That's the thing on the internet, you will always find someone who's going to complain, just no matter what, and it's pissing me off. Like, I had someone complain in my Worms of Arcadia let's play that I wasn't lockpicking enough, that I gave up after only 8 attempts. I'm like, yeah, okay, if I had made 100 attempts, some other guy would come along, oh, 100 attempts, I would never allow that in my D&D group, burr, 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 burr. So what's the best number, what am I allowed to, should I have asked other people, I don't know. Another big problem I have at the moment is the total lack of motivation. I don't know if either my depression rises up again, it is that time of the year, or if I'm just badly overworked. And, I mean, I have absolutely no motivation for anything, and that pisses me off a lot. I really want to draw, for example, but I have no motivation setting up my Cintiq, which is just plugging it in and setting it up, but I just, bleh, the mere thought of doing that, the thing is right next to me. It just like, ugh, no, and I hate hate that feeling. I hate that feeling when you don't feel like doing anything. It's just so fucking horrible. Oh no. And yeah, so I guess maybe I'm going to take a break from streaming again for a bit. Or unless I find a really great game that I want to play repeatedly. I don't know. I think I don't know. That's my main gripe I have at the moment with streaming, that I have just nothing to play where I know what I want to play. I mean, I could replay one of my older games, yes, but again, lack of motivation. The mere thought of doing it is just. I could play FTL Isaac until the cows come home, but again, I mean, I like to. I just played Isaac for a few hours since I came home, and it was fun. But streaming is a totally different. I envy people like Lethalfrag, who says that he's looking forward to stream all the time, and he enjoys it so much. It's hard to describe it. I'm not hating streaming, but maybe it's just me personally. It raises a lot of anxiety in me nowadays. Maybe because of the depression slash burnout or an ongoing upcoming burnout. I don't know. It's just I feel I need to, like on the spot, I need to be funny, and I need to be funny now for 3 hours. And I don't want to say I have a lot of gripes with the chat at the moment. Chat is fairly fine so far. It's just that sometimes it's things are being said or happened, and it just pisses me off. For example, I hate it when people ask me the same question over and over and over again. And it's different with other streamers, like Lethalfrag, for example. He has 280,000 followers. So it's quite possible that if people ask him the same question all the time, that it's different people. But I have the same 14 people, like every stream. There is no new person, not much, a lot of rotation going on. And when I have to answer the same questions all the time, it just makes me so unbelievably angry. Because, as stupid as this might sound, it's one of my triggers. Because my parents used to do this. Every time they wanted something from me, or like tried to force me to do something, they were just repeating the same question over. Could you do this? Why don't you do this? And if I give them reasons why I don't do that, or didn't do that, or don't want to do it. Every time different reasons. But they still kept asking the same questions. And I'm just like, until I gave up, until I was just, okay, fuck it, I'm doing it. Just to not have to talk with you again. That's why it still pisses me off when people ask me to play Might and Magic 6. I don't find it funny. It's just not funny to constantly still hear when are you going to play Final Fantasy 6, even though I finished it already. Or when are you going to play this? When are you going to play that? And I always say I have no schedule. I have no schedule. Most of the time I don't know 10 minutes before the stream starts what I'm going to play. I don't know how I feel like playing next week. Maybe I feel like playing FTL. Maybe I feel like playing a strategy game. Maybe I feel like playing Dungeon Master. Maybe I feel like playing, I don't know. Maybe a new indie game comes out that looks really awesome and I want to play that. How is it possible for me to plan something ahead? I don't know. And or questions like, hey, when are you going to show yourself on camera? And I always say, I'm not going to show myself on camera. I have legitimate reasons that I don't want to show myself on camera. But people don't seem to care for that. I don't know. I don't know if they want to bother me with that, or I don't. I don't know, especially the camera thing. This is just something that is totally out of the question. I just don't want it. I know streamers who used to show themselves daily on camera stopped doing it because it was just too much of a burden for them. Having constantly people talk about your appearance, especially on the internet, especially when you are anxious and constantly. No. No. I get enough shit of people telling me how much they hate my voice. I don't need people telling me, oh, your beard looks stupid. Oh, your hairline is receding. I don't need that. Just accept it. I'm not going to show myself on camera. And things like that. And I even have days where I just get randomly angry of that. That people constantly ask me the same questions over and over and over again. And it's just, I don't know. And that's my main problem I have at the moment with streaming in general. It's just not fun for me. Same with Let's Playing. I mean, I have this shift every few months or so. Then I go back to Let's Playing and oh, Let's Playing is so awesome. Then I record Let's Plays and upload them. But then nobody comments on them, and I'm like, yeah, okay, I kind of miss the instant gratification or instant feedback I have while streaming. So I go back to streaming until I'm like, yeah, okay, I get feedback, but also a lot of problems. So back to nothing. And then I'm like, yeah, I kind of miss playing games on for the internet. Am I going to stream now or Let's Play? I don't know. Let's try streaming most of the time again. Oh, people bother me. I go back to Let's Play. It's just a vicious, endless cycle of shit. It just pisses me off. I mean, I am at a point where I'm fairly certain I will never become a big streamer or a big YouTuber. And I can accept this slowly but steadily. But I still kind of want is at least a little bit of consistency. Tiny little bit. And I don't know, when you do something, especially since I do something for free, it's not hard to just make a fucking comment or something. I don't know. And that's one problem I have at the moment. I mean, then the depressions come again. And I had this discussion today with one of my coworkers slash friends. And I was like, on Friday, we had a team event. And I didn't go because A, I'm feeling miserable at the moment anyway, so I would have just dragged everyone down. B, I'm introvert as fuck. Even if I know the people, as soon as we reach a certain point of people at one place, it just drains me completely, especially when it goes on for like 8+ hours. It's just, I could never work at a place where 40 people are in a really smallish area, or where you constantly have to talk with 40 people at a time. You walk past the corridor and everyone is just, oh, it would just go crazy. So, yeah, I'm desperate. So I was alone at work, and I have a lot enough work to do. I mean, I'm not. I have 108 hours overtime just this year, so I have enough work to do. And I was sending messages to my coworkers who are away, and I also felt this dreadful loneliness because nobody was there at the office. And they also didn't reply like immediately or within an hour or so. And I mentioned this today to her, and she was like, "But I replied to everything." And I was like, "Yeah, maybe I'm over-dramatizing. Maybe I'm a drama queen at the moment. You know, I'm putting don't take everything I say with a grain of salt." And that's also what I have to say about this video. Take everything I say with a grain of salt. Well, except the don't ask me the same question over and over and over and over again because it pisses me off to no end. And but like with this commenting or so, I don't know. It's I don't know what I expect. I can't expect to upload a video and 20 people comment on it or so. I don't know. I can't force it. If there's nothing to comment on in the video, then maybe I'm doing something wrong. Maybe I should ask more questions. Like, hey, I don't know. I don't know what for questions. Maybe I should ask more. That's the thing. I mean, when I started Let's Playing, I can safely say I was a totally different person when I started Let's Playing. I didn't have crippling depression. I didn't have this burnout. I usually started my day, like, I woke up, then I recorded a Let's Play for an hour and uploaded that hour every day. And I could talk about how my progress was in with my thesis, my bachelor thesis, or another game I played at the moment or so. But since I kind of only play, except Isaac, for example, play games that I already that I own. Let me start this again. Most of the games I play at the moment are games I stream. I rarely play something private, quotation mark. Except for example, Isaac. But I wouldn't sit down now and say, okay, I'm going to play Seven Mages for myself. I started doing it, then I lost interest in it for an after an hour because motivation. And yeah, so the games that you see on my YouTube channel in the last year are the games that I played this year. It's not a lot, considering for a gamer. Considering for someone who gamed his whole fucking life. Don't know. It's not hard. It's not easy. But yeah, so I don't know. I'm at this point again where I just don't know what I want to do. And what do I want to say? Yeah, I don't know. I hope this phase goes over soon. It also affects my ketosis, like badly. I mean, when you the problem is one of the main problems I have with the ketosis is I like to eat a warm meal once per day. As stupid as it may sound, I like having a warm meal. But for a warm meal, you usually have to stand in the kitchen. And when I have 2 to 3 hours overtime per day, I just don't feel like cooking anything. I literally don't feel like standing in the kitchen and cooking grilled cheese. It just makes me, I don't know. It's not easy. So I order stuff, or I fetch a kebab or a boy home and something like that. And I really hate this overtime stuff. The main problem is that one of my co-workers is in Australia now, and he's one of the developers. And we don't have many developers. It's like a third of the workforce. To the people who suggest, oh, just look for a different job. No. I still like the job, the company, and so on. And I have so absolutely no self-esteem that I just can't apply for another job even if I wanted to. That's the main problem. So yeah, maybe I figure something out until the weekend. I would say don't expect any streams or videos in the future. Maybe if I feel like doing it, I may throw in an FTL one here and there, or an Isaac one, or I don't know, but there is absolutely no consistency going on at the moment. Even if I stream Saturday and Sunday next weekend, that doesn't mean that I'm going to stream Saturday and Sunday next week and the next week and the next week. I mean, I gave people a lot of options to see when I am online, that I hope I don't need this consistency for people to check. I mean, I say again, Paladin Lord and Epicy, for example, streamers I love to watch, they also don't have a schedule. They stream when they feel like it. And I can safely say that in the past few months, unless I was asleep, I missed none of their streams. I when I'm I have Chrome open all the time and I see, oh, six people are streaming. And in half an hour I see, oh, seven people are streaming. Oh, well, ooh, hey, Belly is streaming. I may miss the beginning, but that's not really a problem usually when people stream for 8 hours. And not to mention, I mean, I have work, so even if I would stream during the week, it won't be any earlier than 5 to 6 p.m. my time. Unless there's a holiday. And even on the weekends, I mean, the majority of my fan base is American. And even people on the stream, I would say 50% are American. Also 50% European something. I doubt I will ever stream really early, even during a weekend. And if, then I maybe will stream until I fall asleep or so. So yeah, even if I have no schedule, there's a certain time frame where I can only stream. So I'm not that hard to catch, even if I have no schedule. Maybe if I really work without a schedule, I don't have this pressure going on all the time, like you must go online now. I go online when I feel like it. But of course, when I go online when I feel like it and there's nobody watching, then yeah, guess what? I'm not going to stream. Anyways, I just wanted to talk about that so people know. I like transparency. I like it when people know why I'm not uploading or exporting things to YouTube or so, and yeah. Anyways, I thank you for watching. I well, guess hope you enjoyed it or so, I don't know. And we will see each other soon, so take care and goodbye.